So if you're into mergers, EVs, or stocks nicknamed the Tesla killers, then you probably heard the updated news about the new and upcoming IPO from an EV company called Hyliion Motors. Now, I've spoken about this company before in a previous video, which I'll reflect on a few times, but I'm a lot more excited about this IPO. Hopefully you guys are too. Let's get started. What's up, guys? My name is Darren Jackson. Hopefully you're having a great day so far. And yes, Hyliion Motors is once again on the news, this time finalizing their merger with Tortoise Acquisition Corp. And we all know what good news for a company does for its stock price. So I'm sure a lot of people are investing in this company right now, but what exactly are the details with this merger? And what does it mean for EV companies altogether? It's a good question. So like I said before, guys, I made a video about this before. I'll leave a link up here. So make sure you guys check that out before you check out this video, just to kind of give you some mindset on where my mindset was prior to getting this new news. But again, I'm really excited about this merger, and hopefully I can help you guys with some information on this merger and what it can mean to your stock portfolio if you've already invested into it. So with this video breakdown, we're gonna be talking about, once again, what ticker symbol Shll really is, what Hyliion Motors is, and why they're merging. Then we're gonna go into the actual details of the updated news of when the merger will actually take place. And we're gonna go over the finance aspects of it, what it can mean for the stock price and what the company will be worth in a sense. And then I'm gonna share my opinions on what I actually feel about the company, why I feel like they actually stand out from other EVs, my personal opinions on it from when I released the previous video on it up until a couple of weeks ago, and kind of how I feel about it now and how that justifies the decisions or lack thereof that I made towards the stock. All right, guys, so starting off, what is Shll? So Shll is the ticker symbol for a company called Tortoise Acquisition. They are an acquisition company that does just that. They acquire. All acquisition companies do, as far as I know. So their mindset is to acquire a company that pretty much supports their cause of energy and electric vehicles and creating a cleaner planet, companies such as like Tesla. And they've IPO'd back in 2015. And from 2015 to maybe earlier this year, their share price ranged late nines, early $10 a share. It wasn't until June when they finally announced their merger agreement with an EV company called Hyliion Motors. Yes, Hyliion Motors is an EV company started, I believe, in 2015 by a guy named Thomas Healy from Austin, Texas. And this company shares the same mission as Tortoise Acquisitions, but with an interesting twist, and we'll get into that pretty shortly. All right, so now getting into the big news itself when it comes to these two companies, the merger has finally been announced to take place on Monday, September 28th. So whatever app you use, whenever the stock market opens on September 28th, when you view it, you will see Shll being replaced by ticker symbol HYLN for Hyliion Motors. Should be an exciting day. Now, the finance part of it is pretty interesting. So whenever they IPO, they're expected to have a market cap value of about $1.5 billion. And that $1.5 billion mostly takes place from a pipe from Tortoise Acquisition and from another company that I'll briefly mention later on, so don't worry about that. And also don't worry if you don't know what a pipe investment is. I promise you, I didn't know either, so I took it upon myself to Investopedia that mess. And PIPE stands for Private Investment in Public Equity. Basically what that means is a company invested into Hyliion Motors privately, and they got the benefit of purchasing these shares at a discounted price. Now, the overall benefit of that is that, for one, they're saving money because they're not purchasing at full price. And two, typically pipe investments or pipe transactions, I guess we can call it, probably makes more sense. They are a lot quicker to help a company get into an IPO rather than the traditional aspect, which can take months. This process actually takes weeks. Now, the only thing I'm concerned about is I'm not really sure how that's going to impact stockholders, because if you've purchased this stock within the past couple of weeks, it's possible that once the IPO hits, that for a period of time, the stock price is going to go down, because apparently the $1.5 billion is supposed to be divided to shares worth $10 a share. So I'm not sure if that means if you bought the stock at, let's say, I don't know, $30, that when the IPO starts, it's gonna drop it down to 10. Hopefully that's not what it is. Even then, it may shoot up, who knows? I'm not too sure about that, but that's something we'll find out. So as I previously said before, I feel like this company as an EV company stands out in its own special way, and their own process to ultimately creating a cleaner planet is a bit different, but really interesting. So they essentially have two different options on how they can create a better planet with their vehicles. The first one is their Hypertruck ERX, which they previously announced, I wanna say in May or June or April, earlier this year. And this is a fully electric vehicle for the most part. So what I mean by the most part is that it actually has a RNG tank where it holds the renewable nitrogen gas, I believe. Can't believe I don't remember that. But it has an option to either use that gas when it's on the road or convert to the actual electric battery that it also has. And there's a generator within it that uses the RNG to charge the electric battery. So it works in its benefit, especially because there's a lot of states that recommend you only use one or the other if you're a Class 8 vehicle. And the Hypertruck ERX isn't supposed to be released until 2022. The other option is what's really interesting. So the other option is they have a hybrid diesel solution. It's essentially components that are able to be attached to any type of Class 8 vehicle, supposedly any type of Class 8 vehicle. It adds on apparently maybe 600 to 800 pounds, and considering the regular weight of most Class 8 vehicles, that's not a lot. So I would think that's pretty efficient. But the way that works is amazing. It's adding on a lot of components to it, such as an electric axle, a in-cab display, and a control unit, which is probably the most interesting add-on, at least in my opinion. What the control unit does is that it measures the topography of your travel. So, you know, the hills and stuff like that. Basically, whenever your vehicle's going downhill, it'll preserve a lot of energy. And when it's going uphill, it'll use that energy, essentially making the vehicle more efficient. So I think that was pretty cool. And at the time of my previous video, I knew that information and I thought that was cool. But mind you, in the mindset of an investor that only invests about $50 a week into their portfolio, I wasn't quite ready to invest any money into it yet. But as time went on, I felt like that this would be a good opportunity to at worst make a little bit more capital once the IPO hits, because we've seen other companies such as Nikola, another EV company that I've made a video about, shoot up from maybe $30 a share to almost 100 within the first weeks or so of the IPO hitting. So worst case scenario, you get a decent amount of capital if you invest at the right time. So with that being said, I decided to take some of that birthday money, I don't know if you remember when I mentioned that, and I invested about $80 into the company at $26.99 a share at the time. Since then, the price has ranged between $49 to $55 a share, and that's after the news outbreak itself. So I can't imagine what the price will be like once the actual merger takes place. And this is probably me being optimistic, but I do picture it at least getting as high as Hyliion Motors did faster, and it actually hitting the triple digits, early $100. And there's a few reasons why I see that, especially comparing it to another IPO EV like Nikola Motors. First of all, the infrastructure for a company like Hyliion Motors is already there. So it's less money the company has to take out of its own pocket to create its own infrastructure, unlike Nikola Motors. The second thing is this company is already scheduled to make a lot of money in the future, hundreds of billions of dollars within the next 3 to 5 years. The reason behind that is the third, and in my opinion, the most important reason, especially when you compare it to Nikola Motors, they already have experience with trucks being on the road. Not necessarily the ERX, they actually already have pre-orders from a logistics company called Agility. Agility is a company that's also taking part into the pipe transaction. I mentioned that earlier. They've also tested their hybrid diesel solutions on Class 8 vehicles for thousands of miles. So they know their vehicles work. They have experience with that. So that's the biggest thing I'm excited about. And I'm hoping, and I'm pretty confident, that the 3 shares of stock that I've already personally made almost $80 on will continue to increase once the merger hits on September 28th. But we're gonna have to see. But I don't know, guys, let me know what you guys think about this company. How do you guys feel about investing into IPOs, let alone mergers? I know it could be a flip of a coin, but let me know what you think about this company in particular, and make sure you guys watch some of these other videos. Hopefully they help you guys in your investing journey as they have in mind. I appreciate you guys watching this video, and until next time, take care.